and switch on the generator so I can turn you on. You better get to know your operator before you pack that tone. You own the lock and the key for the window to my soul. Yeah, that's the only thing you talk about. You gotta let me know, 'cause it must have been something out of control. Yeah, it must have been worth it, 'cause I had nothing left to show. The sun in an elevator and took it to my home. I'm still living on a ladder from the sky to the floor. Don't look down, you got a long way to go. And if you wanna live, you better let the man go. 'Cause it must have been some.
Yeah. when he was off at the September, he was finished. He's not going to do the moment, is he? He's got a paddle ball. He's not going to do the again, he's going to win that one, Damon. Oh, right, he's going to win. I saw a believer. Yeah, he's going to win.
Come on, Bathgate! Let's see this and get more good! Dalkeith, keep your hands up here, come on!
Let's go, Come on, Robo! Come on, Lisa! Get that boy in here!
Andy Colley, Bathgate manager. Today's match against Dalkeith Thistle through at King's Park finished 1-1. Boys got off to a cracking start, but sort of fell out of the game after that, I thought.
No, I agree with you. You know, total control, first 15, 20 minutes, maybe 25 minutes. You know, lovely football. Controlled the play, controlled the tempo of the game, you know, which I've asked them to do. Had one or two wee chances, but nothing clear cut, and then we had a good interplay with two or three of the players. Feeney broke into the box and, you know, was awarded a penalty. You know, so he took it himself, scored for that. Then the last probably 15, 20 minutes, it was a bit even. They started to come into the game. They get a free kick. No, so their goal, which I still can't understand how the referee gave it. You know, they've got a guy, his feet, one of his foot is in Graham McDonald's face, 6 foot, you know, it's in the air and the referee's play on. Yet in the second half, he books Hassan, high feet for it, and his foot was at his waist. You know, so we just need consistency. And no, it was really poor refereeing decision, to be honest. It was a blatant foul, blatant offside, you know, but, you know, the boy played to a whistle and got hit the back of the net. So, half-time. went through the boys, what they'd done right and what they'd done wrong, dominated, but then we fell out of it in the second half. It continued, like the last 15 minutes, you know, Dalkeith pressed us and harried us, you know, and they looked more dangerous in the break, to be honest. I don't know if we tired or, I don't know, I need to look at, you know, we worked them hard at training Tuesday, Thursday, you know, maybe just that wee bit too much and our legs sort of died. Last 15 minutes we made some substitutions and on a half hour to go and it livened up a bit, you know, and we had four great chances in the last 15 minutes to wrap up the game, four clear shots in the box, you know, but blocking, the keeper had a great save over the bar, where just a wee bit consistency or a wee bit composure, you know, somebody should have hit the back of the net, but we were probably lucky to be 1-1 at that point, because Dalkeith had two or three chances that missed themselves. But
definitely, yeah.
No, just not the rest is in the second half, to be honest.
And it must be so frustrating, because you know that the first 20-25 minutes, the play that we were getting for the boys really was outstanding at times. Some of the movement and the passing, very sharp. The goal, when it came, was no more than the lads had deserved at that point. So, you know, then to sort of fall out the match, that must be something that you'll be speaking with them on Tuesday and Thursday about, trying to make sure that we don't have a similar situation next week when we go up to Dundee in the Cup.
I mean, they put that much effort into the first 25 minutes, and I don't know if the goal had anything to do with, you know, it came from nothing, offside in the first place, and a blatant foul, and the referee just play on, you know. So I think the boys' heads went down because Dalkeith hadn't even been in the game, to be honest, and to get a goal for nothing, the first really attempt in the 18 yard box, and, you know, the boys hit it sweetly, but the heads went down for there, and, you know, and we never really picked up in the second half to the last 15, and it is disappointing, but something we will need to look at.
And I mean, it's not an easy place to come and play anyway, Dalkeith. They always put up a hard fight. You know, we got 6 points off the two games last season, but that's by no means the norm. So I guess we're standing here today, we're disappointed with the 1-1 draw, and yet 6-7 months' time we get to the business end of the season, we might be looking back and saying, well, you know what, that was actually a good point at Dalkeith that day. It's a bit early in the season to know the significance of a result like this.
I did say to them that I felt it was 2 points dropped, you know, the clear-cut chances that fell to us in the last 15 minutes. But then, you know, if you look at the 45 minutes prior to that, probably Dalkeith had the better of the play, probably could have 2 or 3 goals themselves. So, you know, we're disappointed at dropping 2 points, but avoiding defeat, you know, I said that to the boys, you'd probably take it on a day, but that is disappointing, you know, and to come away with a point for a good Dalkeith team, you take it as well, but just the manner the displays wasn't good enough.
But we move on, and we've got the Scottish Cup next week up north to Dundee. It should be a good day out. You'll be hoping that we can take a few boys up in the bus to cheer the boys on to a good win against Dundee ace Craigie.
Yeah, aye. Know nothing about them, you know. I tried to get a wee scout to go on a scouting mission to Dundee, but I found it kind of hard, you know. So if I'd been in the corner, I probably would have got a lot of volunteers. But no, we need to go in and treat ace Craigie with a respect to deserve, you know. It's their home pitch, so don't know what we're going into, and it'll be a battle, you know, and we just need to roll the sleeves up and see what East Craigie's got, and they can look at us, and, you know, hopefully we can get a good display and we can, you know, get a good win under our belt, but it will be difficult next week, you know.
Well, thanks very much for taking the time to speak to us, Andy.
Hey, boss. Here's Robert.
Cheers.